Good afternoon, thank you for watching Rundlii Gaming. I'm doing another video on Hearthstone Battlegrounds. So we pulled in today. So gain one gold, but you can only do that once per game when it builds up over the game. Jailer, unless they actually buffed him, he's pretty mediocre. Like Seatomb. I think Seatomb and Dragon's gonna be pretty fun too. I know Tentacles usually doesn't do super well. Well, let's see how it goes. Beast Demons, Murlocs, Pyres of War. So, like, an early game might not be bad with Murloc. And we could always do the demon thing, too. Because the first demon would make this a 3-5, which is pretty amazing for early game. But I think also with early game, we also have a 2-2 taunt in addition to whatever thing we land here. So, we should win the first few matches with relative. That's a pretty good effect with something like that. I mean, even with that, we still won pretty easily, but yeah, otherwise, we'd have certainly lost. Yeah, let's do Tavern Tier. Means most likely next round we would want to do a purchase. This is actually a pretty decent board state because we can basically buy this, sell it, effectively only spending one. Effectively, we would just make that go pretty strong. Go plus two, and then two Murlocs in the field. So that's a good tie as well. Yeah, so I think the direction we wanted to go with this would be this. Sell that one. Drop this one. And this basically gives us a free coin later. One extra tentacle, 3-3. That said, I almost do wish what they would do with this is make it an actual minion that you can actually interact with, so you can actually trigger with like rebirth and you know, other special effects as well. I guess because it comes in summoned, then it's not as strong as it could be. Or even if they redid it where it's similar to the other effects where it will summon once it has room, I think that would be a little bit better of a play with it as well. Then kind of late game you can also use that to sell it for a coin as well, if nothing else. So these are free plus one counters on the tentacle, so we're just gonna buy them and sell them. Since we didn't actually spend any coins doing it. He doesn't really help us a great deal. Let me go counter again. Oh yeah. That's a 5/5. And I think we're keeping up on Tavern Terror. So it's a 3/2, 2/2, 2/2, 2/2, 3. And this guy's pretty much built to go up Tavern Terrors as well. So I'd like to think they have a stronger board state than most of what's out here right now. And then we proceed to lose. Just fine. Do we just play greedy? Yeah, I'll play greedy on that one. There's a few different directions where tentacle still kind of works. We almost kind of want to go in the same direction you would take, like, say, a magma walk, which is for everything you put in the battlefield, but at the end of the round it gets +1/+1. And, so you're kind of building a very similar style build to that. Which basically means you want to find a means of being able to buy and sell creatures as quickly as possible. And the two ways to kind of do that would either be like your Murloc setup or your Pirate setup, because they both can bring in extra creatures. You can put them in play, sell them, put them in play, sell them. What I can say though is AI has not been in our friend in this game. I mean, extra battle cries isn't too bad. It's still pretty terrible. I guess I'm a long-term investment sort of setup. He would be better. At least he buffs everything later. I was certainly hoping that we would get something useful to work with all that. As I said, we could have easily killed another round, but AI has not been our friend this game. I mean, we are going to be playing Battlegrounds minions from here on. So these are free cells, so I do want to take those. I guess this would be our next best choice. The 10 equals points of 99, so. So we're getting there. So as long as we don't continue losing these rounds, what we're probably going to do is probably go next tavern here, I think. And we're about that point where I think we built up a pretty decent little setup here. Losing by much. Yeah, that's a pretty nice boost. It's kind of boosting it down. So yeah, it's 10-10 so far. So playing against Quilt War. So the guy that hit us for 7 hit this person for 10. I do understand what's around it now, so you got both top sevens, but Quill Wars is on his way out. Murlocs not doing too good. So yeah, pirates are at the top, beasts, demons, Murloc. This one relatively easily. I know this doesn't have our board state much, however. So we should sell that ornate space for a big guy. Hmm. Do we want to just push for Magma Lock now? No, I think we wreck our board state too much because we don't sell Saddle. So we probably want to keep that for next round. So the next thing we'll probably be getting rid of would be those Murlocs. I don't think transforming anything here would be particularly useful. I mean, we could give taunt. And plus 12 health. So the goal here basically is to build this out. I don't know if the Master of Realities comes in without elementals or not. So that would be kind of its own little separate question. Because since it's not itself technically an elemental, it's hard to say. Battlegrounds, we at least can benefit from it. This has Battlecry. So now this is actually a Battlecry, but what we could do is actually grab this and sell it. Just for purposes of buffing something else. Yeah. Out of the things though that could have been buffed, that was not the one I wanted. Because we're kind of using him just as a minor buff to everything for the time being until we sort of build out this more. The thing is, too, since we are basically going with pretty much every creature type, nearly. Because, I mean, this is a dragon, in addition to being a Murloc. This is actually just a Murloc, this is also an elemental. And then, like, one or two more creature types. We could also very easily go with a 6-drop, which is the Mantid Queen. You know, for every creature type you have, it can give, like, +5/+5 taunt, or, you know, Divine Shield, etc. The rats took us down on this one. We survived the round, but took some damage for sure. I don't think we can quite make this as beneficial as I'd hoped. Yeah. Sounds good. I guess we can get rid of this. Boost that. Close one now. It looks like we do survive another round. So probably buff you. This might backfire, but I I'm also doing this because it at least reduces the one thing it needs to trigger. Says two more players. I forgot to notice that earlier, but I guess because of the tentacle here, I think that counts as the bees. So it actually gives us another creature type for this one, which is actually pretty good too. So we almost have a menagerie build. Oh, we have two of these Murloc elementals, but. I guess since we're basically building on the idea of flooding things out a bit, then. It's not too bad. Like, I'm debating on whether or not we want to freeze it for this. It's pretty much the only thing in this whole thing that's even all that useful. Like, and since it is, you get two Murlocs out of it. Yeah, it basically buys itself. Alright, so we're playing against the Leapfrog. I think we took this one at least. I actually thought we might have problems with that one. But not only that, we eliminated them. So we should have problems with them again. So, yeah, we'll grab this one. I don't think we're quite building super well around that idea. So that might be a better play. I'm gonna buff him out quite a bit. And we could potentially go for the golden version of him. Just for purposes, I don't know. I actually want to keep I was like, we can put another creature type, but then, yeah, we won't do that. Well, unfortunately, it was a loss, but it was actually pretty close. I think we actually had some pretty decent odds to take that victory, actually. But otherwise, thank you all for watching. You all have a wonderful day.